Now we will discuss shear force and bending moment diagram for a cantilever beam which is subjected to point load at the center and propped at the free end. First of all, in this case what I am doing is I am drawing a cantilever beam which is having a prop at the free end and which is subjected to a point load at a distance of L by 2 from the fixed end and at a distance of L by 2 from the other end of the cantilever portion. In this, I am considering the end support, the vertical prop which I am considering as which is possessing a reaction of some RA and this end as A, and the fixed end I am considering it as B, and here the point where the point load is acting has some C. The total length of the beam I am taking it as L. For this, I want to find out the vertical reaction at the support A or the prop reaction. How can I find out this vertical reaction or the prop reaction means? First of all, I want to undergo for the downward deflection due to the applied loads to the upward deflection due to the prop reaction. I am considering this prop reaction also as a load which is occurring at the free end of the cantilever and the deflection is occurring in upward direction. That means, if you see here, first of all, I am considering a cantilever beam which is subjected to the which is subjected with the point load at a distance of L by 2 from the fixed end and L by 2 to the free end, and this is case 1. In this case 1, due to this applied load, there will be a downward deflection of the beam. In the case 2, what I am considering is, I am considering the cantilever beam which is subjected with a point load with a reaction of RA. Due to this, what will happen means the beam will deflect upwards. And this is the case 2. So, if I want to find out the vertical reaction at the prop, I want to equate this deflection due to downward loading equal to the deflection due to upward loading. So, first of all, I am finding out the deflection due to downward loading. Downward deflection due to load of intensity W. YC, I am considering at point C, which is at the center, YC equal to W into L by 2 whole cube by 3EI plus W into L by 2 whole square by 2EI into L by 2. This you will get it in the deflection of the beams. In this case, what I am doing is I am considering a cantilever beam which is subjected to the point load at a distance of at the center of the beam. For this will be the deflection. You will get it as W L cube by 18 to 3 24 EI plus W L cube by, and this is also 18 to 2 16 EI. Totally, you will get it as, if you take the LCM of 16 and 24, you will get it as 48 into 2W L cube plus 3W L cube equal to 5W L cube by 48 EI. This is the downward deflection for the case 1. Now, the upward deflection for the case 2. For this, what I am doing is I am considering a cantilever beam which is subjected to a point load or some prop reaction at the free end. So there will be a deflection in upward direction. For this, the deflection YC equal to, as I had considered the prop reaction as RA, RA into L cube by 3EI. So, now what I am doing is, Next, in the next step, what I had to do is I had to equate the downward deflection equal to the upward deflection. Upward deflection equal to downward deflection in order to find out the prop reaction. Here we had considered the prop reaction as Ra, or you can write it as some P. In this, we got the upward deflection Ra into L cube by 3EI, and the downward deflection we got it as 5W L cube by 48EI. From this, we need to find out Ra or prop reaction P. So I am separating Ra. Ra equal to 5W by 16. You will get it as Ra equal to 5W by 16. And this is the prop reaction. Now we had to find out the shear force and bending moments at the for this proper cantilever beam. So first of all, I am finding out the shear force for the beam. In this, how can we find out the shear force for the beam means, first of all, I am considering a section XX which is passing at a distance X from the free end. So in this, what I am doing is I am considering a section XX at a distance X from the free end. Now what I am doing is I am taking shear force at section XX to its right. I am considering the forces to its right. If you consider to its right, we are having the vertical reaction Ra or the prop reaction Ra, and it is in upward direction. So what I am doing is I am taking it as minus Ra. Therefore, the shear force at XX, it will be minus 5W by 16. This will be the shear force reaction at section XX. Now, what I am doing is I am considering whether the section is equal or varying throughout the beam or not. In this, for that, what I am doing is I am considering shear force of XX. Instead of taking right, I am considering this section here. Now it is also at a distance X. For this case, if you see here, the section is moving at a distance of X from the free end. So in this case, the shear force at section XX to its right equal to minus Ra plus W. As the central point load, it is acting downwards. So what I am doing is I am taking it as plus W equal to minus 5W by 16 plus W. You will get it as minus 5W plus 16W by 16 equal to, in this we got it as shear force at XX right, to its right, minus 5W plus 16W by 16 equal to 11W by 16. And you will get, if you plot the shear force diagram, I am plotting it here, 5W by 16 downwards below the neutral line, and I am plotting plus 11W by 16 to its top. Here this 11W by 16, it is constant up to the point C. So I am drawing it in the form of a straight line, whereas 5W by 16, it is also constant in between C and A. So I am denoting it with a straight line here. So as this is pushing a negative value, so I am representing it as my negative shear force, and this 11W by 16, it is pushing a positive value, so I am representing it with plus sign. Now we will discuss about the bending moment diagram for this proper cantilever case. For bending moment, what I am doing is I am considering a section XX like in the previous case, which is at a distance X in between the portion A and C. In between the portion A and C, I am considering a section X. For this, what I am doing is, suppose I am considering the bending moment at A. A means at the end A, then what will be the bending moment is, probably it's a vertical support, at the support the bending moment value will be 0. That means now what I am doing is bending moment just to left of A. Suppose I am just considering a section just to the left of the end A. Then what will be the bending moment means, bending moment equal to, as it is a anti-clockwise moment, I am considering it as Ra into x. In this, bending moment just to C, at the point C, that means at x equal to L by 2, we will get it as Ra into L by 2, that equal to phi w by 16 into L by 2. You will get it as phi w L by 32, and this will be the bending moment at the C. Now what I am doing is, I am considering the bending moment just to left of C. That means my section is traveling from the point C to its left. So at that case, what will be the bending moment means, Ra into x minus W into x minus L by 2. For this, we had to find out what will be the x distance. In this case, I am considering the bending moment at the fixed end, that means at B. Then x equal to L equal to phi W by 16 into L minus W into L minus L by 2 equal to phi W L by 16 minus W into L by 2. If you take the LCM, you will get it as 16 phi W L minus 8 W L. You will get it as minus 3 W L by 16. And this will be the bending moment at B. In this, we got it as phi WL by 32, which is a positive bending moment, and 3 WL by 16, which is a negative bending moment. And for this, if you plot it, you will get the bending moment diagram like this. Here, if you observe here, there is a change in bending moment from positive moment to the negative moment. We had to find out where the point of contraflexure is occurring. How can we find out point of contraflexure means, by taking moment at section xx equal to 0. That implies you will get it as Ra into x minus W into x minus L by 2 equal to 0. Phi W by 16 into x minus W into x minus L by 2 equal to 0. Phi W x by 16 minus WX plus W L by 2 equal to 0. If you see here, what I want to find out X terms. So what I am doing is, I am separating these X terms, phi W X by 16 minus 16 W X equal to minus W L by 2. Now what I am doing is, if you see here, I am cancelling the denominators 8, and here you will get it as minus 11 W x by 8 equal to minus W L. W cancel, x equal to minus minus cancel, 8 L by 11. This will be the distance where the bending moment is changing its sign, and this will be the point of contraflexure. And this will be the length, and this is 8L by 11 from the free end. Why? Because here we had considered the section, it is traveling from the free end. So this 8L by 11, it will be at a distance from the free end. And if you see, get this distance means, you will get it as 3L by 11. Why? Because how you will get that distance means, total length is L. So L minus 8L by 11, you will get it as 3L by 11, this will be the distance from the fixed end.